For question number 11, the correct option is option 1. And to show the steps of solution, in my very first step, let me draw a figure to understand the situation of the question, right? So this is the figure I have shown. Already I have hinted above that an oblique two-dimensional elastic collision, if a particle hits against a wall, then the component of velocity parallel to the wall remains unchanged, while component of velocity perpendicular to the wall reverses in direction without any change in magnitude. Now, keeping this in mind, you understand this figure I'm drawing here. This is the wall shown in this solid white line. This is a typical hydrogen molecule before collision approaching the wall obliquely, and this is situation of the molecule just after the collision. Okay, mass of each molecule is taken to be m, velocity vector is v, say I'm just writing a scalar symbol for the magnitude part only. This velocity is hitting the wall at an angle of theta, that is 45 degree with the normal drawn on the wall. So if this theta is obvious, this angle is also theta, this angle is theta, and this angle is theta. So this v velocity has got two components. One is vx. Well, let me show here coordinates chosen. I choose a system of coordinates for which plus x axis pointing rightwards horizontally, plus y axis pointing vertically upwards on your screen. So the x component is vx, y component is vy before the collision. After this elastic collision, the y component parallel to the wall remains unchanged in magnitude and in direction, is vy only, while the component perpendicular to the wall gets reversed without changing magnitude. Therefore, I can write down here, after the collision, but the velocity v, magnitude remains same, but the x component becomes now minus vx because of reversal of direction. So that's the figure to understand, right? You also take down some data given in the question for future use, that mass of each hydrogen molecule given to be 3.32 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg, number of collisions per second, that is 10 to the power 23 per second. The area of the wall that is given to be 2 centimeters square, converting into standard SI, that will be 2 into 10 to the power minus 4 meters square. Be careful about conversion into the right unit. Angle theta given to be 45 degree, and also the speed of the molecule before and after the collision remains unchanged at 10 to the power 3 meter per second. This is the step number 1, drawing a figure and taking down the data given in the question. Moving on to my next step, you can look at the figure and can find out the change in momentum of the hydrogen molecule in each collision, right? So that is symbolically delta P for a typical molecule. See, after the collision, the x component becomes minus Vx, given by my sign convention. Before collision, it was Vx in the plus direction. Therefore, momentum change, the final value of linear momentum, that is m into minus vx. As you understand, the y component doesn't change, only x component changes. So after the collision, momentum's x component is m into minus vx. Subtract from it momentum before the collision, x component, that is m into vx, coming out to be minus twice mvx. Let me write it somewhere on the figure, Vx is equal to V into cos theta. It's clear from this figure. X component is V into cos theta. Now that was for the momentum change per collision of the molecule. Now what is the corresponding momentum change of the wall per collision? For that, you recall principle of conservation of linear momentum. This says that for the molecule plus wall system, in the absence of external forces, let me write it, delta P for the system, system here is comprised of molecule and the wall. So this is the summation of momentum change of molecule and momentum change of the wall during the collision. This must be equal to zero in the absence of an external force acting on the system. So it follows therefore that during each collision, the change in momentum of the wall, that is equal to negative of the change in momentum of the molecule. That is, see here, already found delta P molecule is minus 2m Vx. So a minus of that giving you plus twice m Vx. Once again quickly, a minus sign here and delta P molecule itself is negative. It's coming out to be positive twice m Vx. And that is, you can write it as twice m into V into cos theta. Before I go to next step, we note that this last result is the momentum change of the wall per collision. So in step number 3, we'll find out momentum change of the wall per second. Now what is that? Symbolically, that will be dp dt for the wall. Isn't it? Rate of change in momentum of the wall per second, dp dt is that. That will be momentum change per collision multiplied by the frequency of collision, number of collisions per second. So you can write it, dp dt is n into delta p for wall, that is n into twice mv cos theta is giving me twice m into n into v into cos theta. I'm writing everything in symbol. We'll put the data in the last step. Twice mn v cos theta, but by Newton's second law, once again, apply Newton's second law, that force equal to the change in momentum rate of the body on which the force is applied. Therefore, this dp dt for the wall is nothing but the force exerted on it by the colliding molecules. So F is equal to dp dt by second law of Newton, and that is found to be twice mnv cos theta, momentum change per second. Once you come so far, we can write in the next step, that is step number 4, the pressure on the wall, capital P. We have used earlier small p for this momentum, now use capital P for pressure. This pressure will be the force by area of the wall, and that is coming out to be twice mnv cos theta divided by area of the wall, that is A. Until now we have got things in symbolic form. So in the last step, we can put the numerical data from above and write down, well, data is listed here. So let's start. Twice m, mass of each molecule, 3.32 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg. Then comes n, the collision frequency, 10 to the power 23 per second. Then comes V, the speed, 10 to the power 3 meter per second. then cos theta, that is cos 45 degree 1 upon root 2 divided by the area of the wall, that is 2 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter square, isn't it? So complete the calculation and show that the value of P we are getting to be 2.35 into 10 to the power 3 Newton per meter square, and this was the option 1 given in the question. So our choice is option 1.